longest audience. I must mention that Admiral Robin Dhawan's wonderful speech and Mrs. Gargi call casting certain doubts on the process. My speech. But having said that, I want to congratulate Sandesh and Fiki for organizing this seminar in spite of the ongoing pandemic on this very important aspects of presence modernization, namely managing leasing for force level maintenance and modernization. But notwithstanding the COVID slowdown, I want to assure you that the armed forces are focused on modernization and are receptive to any new ideas and proposals which facilitates the same. I've structured my address to focus on the armed forces' objectives in the emerging security scenario, capabilities required to meet these objectives, existing constraints in modernization and capability development, the new provision of leasing in DAP 20, advantages of the lease model, leasing requirements of the armed forces, and expectations from the industry. Let me briefly touch upon the emergent security scenario as far as the Navy is concerned. Indian Armed Forces, as all of you are aware, have the honored responsibility to preserve and promote our national interests. This encompasses various roles, from defending the territorial integrity to ensuring a secure environment in and around to facilitate economic activity, to shouldering the responsibility of realizing the Honorable Prime Minister's vision of security and growth for all in the region or SAGR. For Indian Navy, these translate to ensuring highest combat preparedness to deter war, undertaking regular deployments to fight a variety of subconventional threats such as piracy, drug peddling, gun running, human trafficking, and as well as undertaking foreign cooperation initiatives to fulfill our role of being the preferred security partner in the Indo-Pacific.